What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. When you got a Samsung from others and activate it, find out the device is locked with the previous PIN code, or you can use your Google account instead. Then it will ask you to verify your account. What if you actually don't know the Google account? Can you remove it? No worries, in today's video I'll show an efficient tool to help you remove Google account, especially for Android 11 device. Now let's dive right in. To start with, connect your Samsung to the computer. And on the Foro key interface, click on Remove Google Lock section. Then select your device OS version, Android 11. Then click Start. To be noticed that, to remove FRP lock successfully, your Samsung device should be connected to Wi-Fi and on the FRP or PIN lock page. And you should use the same Samsung account in the whole process. And you have another Samsung phone that works. Once confirmed, click Start button. The first part is to backup app on the Samsung phone which has no FRP lock on it. First go to Play Store. Search Alliance Shield and install it. Once done, go to Settings. And if you haven't logged in with your Samsung account, log in first. Then scroll down to find Accounts and Backup. Tap Backup Data. Here we just need to backup the apps. Then tap Backup. Once done, we can move on to the next step. On Foro key interface, click on Next button, and Foro key will send notification to your FRP lock device. When you see the pop-up window on Foro key, click Install. When your FRP lock device receives the notification, move on to the second part, create an environment to restore the backup. Tap View on the notification to open Samsung Galaxy Store. If Galaxy Store requests to update or agree to the terms of service, please follow the instructions to complete. Then enter S9 Launcher in the search bar. You will see S9 Launcher in result. Install and open it. Once done, tap Enter. What you need to do next is to restore the app we backup before on this S9 Launcher. So first go to Settings and log in with the same Samsung account, which is very important. When it's done, scroll down to find Accounts and Backup. Here we choose to restore backup. And choose the latest backup to restore, which is the backup we just created at the beginning in this video. And we just need to select the specific app to restore, Alliance Shield. Then install it. Then we can move on to the third part. Use Alliance Shield to allow the system permissions. Find the app and launch it. And sign in with a username and password. If you don't have an account, please register first. After signing in, name your device to make it easier to identify it for remote management and alerts. Once done, tap Next. Next, you need to turn on some authorities to find the exact file we need to revise. Turn on Device Admin. Tap on Activate. Next, turn on Knox. Then Agree. And tap on Finish. When you see the Alliance Shield homepage, you can see that Admin and Knox are marked with green dots. Everything good. Let's move on. Tap App Manager. Search for Service Mode and tap it. Next, just follow the guidance on Foro key to revise the file. Tap Activities, and find the file with the name containing USB at the bottom. Select it, and tap Open. Check MTP plus ADB, then unplug the USB cable and replug it. On Foro key, click Next. It will start removing the Google lock. If you see the screen flickers after removal, take it easy, it's very normal. All you need to do is to press the volume up and power button at the same time to restart the device. After restart, here comes the final part. Also follow the steps accordingly. Go to Settings and select General Management. Scroll down to find Reset and tap it. Choose Factory Reset. Then tap Reset and delete all. Enter your Samsung account password and tap OK. FRP will be completely removed after the device restarts. Let's skip the unimportant setup part. And when you see the page asking to you sign in with your Google account, instead of the verifying page, which means the FRP lock has been removed completely, you can skip the step and set it up later. And congratulations, now you have already removed the Google account successfully. No more accounts ahead your way. Okay, so that's all for today's video. If it helps, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. I would be very grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next video.